Hello there and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm bringing to you 4 Shopify hacks that you probably didn't know about before. If you are already using Shopify or if you are planning to use Shopify soon, I highly recommend you to watch this video up until the end because the hacks I'm going to show you are truly impressive, especially hack number 2. I can't believe that I only discovered this hack a few weeks ago. It made my work way, way easier, so please check it out. Starting with the hack number 1. If you have been using Shopify for a while, so most probably you know that Shopify offers analytics and reports with the most important metrics you need to check out your website performance and your sales. But what most people don't know is that Shopify allows you to dig deeper into those reports and analytics to understand more your business performance. As a Shopify merchant, you are able to take any default Shopify report and change it to show exactly what kind of information you are looking for. So let's say, for example, you are running Facebook ads and you are running a campaign with multiple ad sets and multiple ads, and you want to know which ads are performing the best or maybe which ad sets are performing the best. What you can do is to go to Shopify Analytics and to spice up your session reports by adding some columns that will help you to understand more which ads or which ad sets are bringing more traffic or more sales. As you can see, when you are checking your report, you can add as much columns as you wish. You can add the refer column, you can add the UTM column, and all of these columns are meant to help you to understand more how to read these reports. If you want to know more about how to use Shopify Analytics, I highly recommend you to check these 2 videos on this YouTube channel. They are meant to help you to understand how to use the Shopify Analytics dashboard in the best way possible. And in addition to adding columns to your reports, you can also use the filtering feature. This feature will allow you to only see the relevant information for you. So let's say, for example, you are running Facebook ads campaigns, email marketing campaigns, maybe doing influencer marketing, and you are using UTM links for all of these marketing strategies. What you can do is to go to Shopify and filter your results by the UTM campaign name. And in this way, you will be able to know the results you are generating out of each of your marketing strategies, so you can judge your marketing strategies properly. And now moving to the hack number 2. I spend so much time working on Shopify, so when I discovered this hack, I was extremely happy. Truly, truly, truly happy. And let me tell you why. It helps me to save time, it makes my workflow on Shopify way, way efficient, and it's very easy and very practical. It's called Shopify Keyboard Shortcuts, and it allows you to quickly move between pages on Shopify or tasks on Shopify just using your keyboard and by typing on your keyboard. If you type the question mark now on your keyboard while you are inside on Shopify, you will be able to see the list of keyboard shortcuts. These shortcuts will take you to create a product, create a page, will help you to move around Shopify in a very easy and practical way. Shopify introduced keyboard shortcuts in order to make admin work much more time efficient and practical. So I highly recommend you to use them. With time, you will start to be more familiar with them and you will memorize most of them. Believe me, they will make your work on Shopify way, way easier. And now moving to the hack number 3. And this hack is also amazing. Shopify allows you to know and discover what your customers are searching for while they are browsing your store. So yeah, you can know what kind of keywords your customers use on the search box, and this will help you to understand what your customers need and what they are searching for. It gives you a breakdown of the specific search terms that your customers use to search for a product in your online store. This information will help you to understand how your customers describe your products and how they search for them. So you can go back to your products, titles, and descriptions and adjust them to make sure that your visitors or your customers are easily finding what they are looking for. And not only that, you can use this report to know if you are driving the right traffic to your store. Let's say, for example, you sell coffee and you notice that many people are searching for cold juice on your store. Well, this is a red flag because it might mean that instead of driving coffee lovers to your store, you are driving cold beverage lovers, and those might not be your potential customers. So as you can see, the search term report is extremely valuable and I highly recommend you to read it and analyze it in order to improve your store. And now we have reached the hack number 4, and it is Shopify automation flows. If you are already one of my YouTube friends, so most probably you know about email marketing because I talk a lot about it. If not, I highly recommend you to check the free workshop I'm currently offering. In this workshop, I explain to you the importance of email marketing and why it is mandatory for any e-commerce business. If you are looking to make your e-commerce business solid and sustainable, you must have an email marketing system set in place. Well, before 2021, we used to create this email marketing system using software like Klaviyo or OmniSend or maybe MailChimp. In 2021, Shopify introduced automation flows, and now you can create your flows within Shopify for free. But let me explain to you first what a flow is. A flow is a series of emails sent automatically to your customers or to your visitors, depending on their behaviors on your store. So we have a flow for the welcome when someone subscribed to our newsletter, or we have flow for people who initiated checkout and didn't buy, or maybe for people who already bought from us and they are waiting for their order to arrive. You can create now all of these flows within Shopify for free. Well, yes, I still recommend you to use Klaviyo because I think it's way better than what Shopify offers, and it's way, way more professional and advanced. But it's totally fine if you are just starting out and you don't have any budget to invest to go with Shopify automation flows. They are a very good starting point for any e-commerce business with zero revenue, for example. On this YouTube channel, there is a video that shows you how you can set up your automation flows using Shopify. And there is also another video that shows you how you can do the same using Klaviyo. So don't forget to check them out and see which one of them you will be going with. I repeat, Klaviyo is the best option for any e-commerce brand, and this is an option that you will go to sooner or later. But as a starting point, you can start with Shopify automation flows. They are fine. So these were my four Shopify hacks. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching it, and thank you for staying up until the end. Before leaving, I want to invite you one last time to go down to the description and to check the free workshop I'm currently offering. In this workshop, I show you how you can create a strong, sustainable e-commerce business. I show you the exact framework that you should be applying to your business in order to make it sustainable and in order to be able to attract, convert, and retain more customers. So don't forget to check it out. It's 100% free and you don't need to pay any dollar. Thank you again for watching this video. Before leaving, don't forget to smash the like button, to subscribe to my channel, and to hit the notification bell, because in this way you will get notified each time I publish a new video. See you next week. Bye bye.